How's it going? Welcome back to my channel. If this is your first time here, thanks for joining. My name is Brandy. Some of you may know me as Live With Biv on Instagram. I do also have a blog at livewithbiv.com. Welcome to my channel! Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and hit the notification bell to be notified of new videos. So today, I have a very special collection for you. I'm going to be reviewing the new Essie Expressie Ahead of the Gamer collection. This is a 10-piece collection that I found at Walgreens, so keep your eye out at Walgreens. I believe they also currently have them at Ulta and on Amazon, so make sure to check those sites out if you're interested. So the Essie Expressie collection is said to be a quick, dry, polished collection, so I can't say that these polishes are long-lasting at all, which I can't say that any polishes are long-lasting because I never wear my polishes for more than 1 or 2 days. So if any of you guys out there have had any experience with Essie Expressie to see how long they last, let me know down in the comments because I get a lot of people asking that question. What I do know about these polishes is they are very quick drying. So they dry within 1 to 2 minutes on your nail. So they're super easy, super fun, on-the-go polishes to wear. And these colors are so fun and so vibrant. So, I'm gonna stop chatting. Let's get to the polishes. So, first up for these beauties is No Time to Pause. This is a gorgeous, vibrant purple that is a two-coater. The first coat was a tad bit more sheer than I thought it would be, but the second coat built up nicely and was perfectly opaque. Getting into the comparisons here, I actually ended up doing a third coat here because as this polish dried down, I felt like it needed one more coat to be perfectly opaque. So here we have the comparisons. I compared this one to Tangled in Love by Essie. You can see that one is much brighter, as is Synthetic Symphony by Orly. And then Banks is almost a little bit more magenta-y looking. Next up for comparisons, I compared Essie Berlin The Club and Hazy Days. You can see both of those are darker than No Time to Pause. And then I also pulled out another purple Essie Expressie IRL or In Real Life, and you can see that one is a bit brighter. Lots of purple comparisons here. Next up we have Essie Serving Looks from their Have a Ball collection. If you guys are interested in seeing that review, I will link it in the cards here. It's quite a bit brighter, as is Essie Shades On and Zoya Skipper from the Zoya Dreamin' collection. And moving right along, we have Essie Making Harmony, and then we have Essie Hold 'em Tight and Sights on Nightlight. And then last but not least, we have Left My Heart in Havana by China Glaze, Essie Wink of Sleep, and Essie Expressie Dial It Up. And once again, no dupes here. No Time to Pause is an absolutely beautiful purple that I think you're all going to love. Okay, and next up, we have Multiplayer Moves. Multiplayer Moves is described as a bright yellow cream, and this is actually more orange than yellow. It is a three-coater. It applies like butter. It's got an absolutely stunningly gorgeous formula, and this is one of my faves in this collection. And then moving right along, we have Don't Hate Curate Tangerine Heat by China Glaze from their Spring 2021 collection. And I'm totally gonna say that this one is a dupe for Multiplayer Moves. And then we have Fall 4 NYC, which is quite a bit darker and more of a fall shade. And then moving right along, we have Essie Souls on Fire from their Summer 2019 Neon collection. Cirque Colors Munchies, which is quite a bit brighter, and Tangerine Dream, which is brighter and more orange. Okay, and then here we have All Things OOO by Essie Expressie, Essie Check Your Baggage, and Essie You're a Catch, and you can see no dupes here. Then I had to compare Feeling Wellies because I was pretty sure it was a dupe, but it was not. It was Feeling Wellies is lighter than Multiplayer Moves. And then we have Delta Darlin', which was pretty close. It looks like it's a dupe in the video, but it was actually a little bit more different in real life. And then last but not least for these comparisons, we have OPI, Marigold and Hour, Essie, You Know the Espadrille, and Orly, Here Comes the Sun, and you can see no dupes here. Oh, you know what? I had to pull one more out. So I grabbed Essie Set in Sandstone because I thought it was going to be close, but it's not. Set in Sandstone is quite a bit more orange. Okay, then we have Thumb Surfing. This is a polish that surprised me more than any of the other polishes. I actually really like this one. I thought it was going to be just another pink, and I honestly didn't care about this one. But once I swatched it, I was like, oh my gosh, this is almost a one coat wonder. Like, it's so good. I did do two coats just for absolute full opacity. But then I compared it, and I was sure this was going to be pretty close to Splash of Grenadine, and it is pretty close. The formula for Thumb Surfing is a little bit more of a cream than Splash of Grenadine is, but the colors are very, very close. And then I also compared it to Suits You Swell by Essie, as well as It Takes a West Village by Essie. And those are all pretty close, really. And then here we have Essie Expressi In the Time Zone, which is much lighter. Essie Expressi Mall Crawler, which is much more sheer. And OPI Lavender to Find Courage, which is more purpley pink. Okay, then the green. This is Take Controller, a vibrant lime green with yellow undertones. This is a two-coater. I did two coats in the live swatch, two coats in the swatch picture. And then here we have the comparison. So I compared this to Essie Expressi Express to Impress, Essie Expressi We Don't Mesh, and Essie Have a Ball from the new Have a Ball collection, and no dupes here. And then next up we have the most requested comparison of them all. Everybody wanted to see how Take Controller looked compared to Come On Clover. So you can see that here. Come On Clover is a little bit more of a pukey green, whereas Take Controller is a little bit more of a brighter pukey colored green. And then we have Doubles Trouble from the Have a Ball collection and Feelin' Just Lime from the Summer 2021 collection. And then here we have OPI Paradise Cove from their Summer 2021 collection, Neon Paradise by Orly, and Link by Zoya, and you can see no dupes here. And then last but not least, I wanted to compare Win Me Over from the new Essie Ferris of Them All collection. No dupes here. All right, and next up, this is my new absolute fave blue. This blue is perfect. I don't know if it stains because I just applied it to swatch it, so more than likely, you should probably wear a base coat if you want to make sure that it doesn't stain. But anyway, this polish is a vibrant cobalt blue, a one coat wonder. Here I compared it to Waterfall in Love, Aruba Blue, and One Night Stand by Cirque Colors. So then I had to compare it to, of course, the blue by Essie that everybody loves, Butler Please. You can see that Butler Please is a bit brighter. Mesmerized is a little bit more muted, and All the Wave is a little bit darker. And then we have Essie Juicy Details, OPI Mi Casa Es Su Casa, and I would say that is a dupe for Beat the Clock. And then Amuse Me from the Ferris of Them All collection is a bit lighter. Next up, we have Essie Style Cartel, Essie Namaste the Night, and Avenue Maintain, and you can see those are all a bit different. Okay, and now Remote Friends. Remote Friends is described as a dusty pink nude, and this was probably my least favorite in the collection just because I don't love how this color of nude looks on my hands. This is a two-coater with an amazing formula. I compare this polish to Sorrento Yourself, Secondhand First Love, and Suit and Tie, and you can see no dupes here. Secondhand First Love is similar, but it's a bit more pink. And then I also compared it to Bear With Me by Essie, as well as Eternal Optimist and Into the Abyss, And you can see no exact dupes here either. Okay, another absolutely stunning polish from this collection. This is a Head of the Gamer. This is an electric coral red. It's so bright, it's so beautiful. It's a two coater and I love it. Here we have it compared to Essie Come Here, Essie Cute as a Button, and Essie Gel Couture Bold Boundaries. And you can see it's a little bit, has a little bit more orange in it. So I compared it to Essie Spice It Up, and you can see Spice It Up is a little bit darker, but Olive and June Lava is pretty similar here. And Leveled Up, this absolutely freaking stunning charcoal gray with blue undertones is a must-have. This is definitely a one-coater, but I did two coats here just because I love dark colors like this that are 100,000% opaque because they're so just deep. I just love them. So Leveled Up, like I said, it's beautiful. Here are comparisons. We have Essie On Mute, Essie Anchor Down, and Essie Cashmere Bathrobe. So I compared it to Essie Expressy Air Dry, Essie Toned Down, and Petal Pushers. And you can see those are all lighter and a tad bit more blue toned. And another absolute favorite from this collection is Virtual Velocity. You guys, get your acetone out because you're gonna need it to remove the glitter from this polish. Just saying, it's totally worth it, but you're gonna need some extra acetone. So this is a two coater. This is not a texture polish. It is a pretty thick polish that I can see getting to be too thick as it ages, and you may have to add nail polish thinner to it, but it's still so worth it. And then getting into the comparisons, I compared Virgin Snow and Lilacism. You can see Virgin Snow is a tad more blue. Lilacism is a little bit darker of a pastel purple, but it's similar, but without the shimmer. And then we have St. Lucia Lilac, which is a tad more grayish toned almost. Goginza is a bit more pink, and then Gel Couture Style in Excess is a little bit darker. And another one with the exact same formula as Virtual Velocity, but this could totally be a one coater. I did two coats here. It's called Don't Glitch, Get Better. This is a deep fuchsia pink with a shimmer finish that you're gonna need loads and loads of acetone to remove. But again, it's totally worth it. It's gorgeous. I compared this to Might Drop It Low, which is a little bit more sheer than this one. This one just builds up so nicely. And then I compared it to Morgan Taylor All Day, All Night, and Essie Head Over Wheels. And then next up we see Flowerista compared to Don't Glitch, Get Better, as well as Jamaica Me Crazy compared. And no exact dupes here. All right guys, so what did you think? Which polish was your fave? Let me know down in the comments. Let me know which collections you are excited to see coming up. And stay tuned. I'm going to have a live coming to you with France from Essie Loves Quebec either this week or next week. What are we going to be talking about? We're going to be talking about all of the new fall collections. So make sure to stay tuned. Also, next week, I'm going to have the new Essie fall collection for you guys. So stay tuned for that. Otherwise, have a great week. You guys are the best. Love you.